हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ रीटा रानी। टुडे आई एम अगेन विद यू विद अ न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ क्लास 10th, प्रिंट कल्चर एंड द मॉडर्न वर्ल्ड। इट इज़ चैप्टर नंबर 7 फ्रॉम हिस्ट्री सेक्शन। आई हैव डिवाइडेड दिस चैप्टर इनटू टू पार्ट्स एंड टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन पार्ट 1। बट बिफोर दैट आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल टू सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल if you have not subscribed till now, and if you like this video, press the bell icon for latest updates. Share it with your friends also. Now let's start the chapter, print culture in the modern world. My dear children, in the modern time, for all of us, this print is not a new thing. There is nothing new in print. Everywhere we can see, like our books we used to read in the class, magazines, newspapers, journals and cinema posters, calendars, they all are the examples of print. They are the evidences of print, printed material. It is not a very new thing for us. It is not a great thing for us. But there was a time when nobody could have ever thought about it. There was a time when the invention of printing machine caused a revolutionary change in the lives of the people, our society, our culture. I think almost all the areas of human life were greatly influenced with this new scientific invention. And this great scientific invention, firstly, it took place in China. Actually, in China also, I think nobody could have ever thought about it. But this invention took place in China. And before its invention, writing of books was completely a manual affair. Means only handwritten books were there. In the art of beautiful and stylish handwriting was called calligraphy. Means at that time, only a few experts, those whose profession, whose work, whose job was to write down the books in beautiful and stylish handwriting, and that was called calligraphy. This invention of wood block printing, it took place, or this scientific invention was invented in China firstly. So what was the reason behind that? Actually, where there is a will, there is a way. So it applies here. In China, demand for books was there. That is why it was thought to find out a way to produce, to provide more and more books in the market. And that technology came into existence. Why books were demanded in a huge number? What was the reason? Actually, in China, a huge bureaucratic system was there. And this bureaucratic system recruited its people through civil service examinations. Like in India, exams for the government jobs are conducted, and many exams for bank jobs, for teaching, every government job exams are there. An IAS exam, you all are very much familiar with this great name. These exams are conducted in our country. Lots of people take part in this exam. They want to be appeared in the exam. And for that, they make great preparations. And for the preparation of the exams, books are required. In the same way, at that time in China, for the government jobs, people were selected through exams. And those civil service examinations were conducted, and for that government wanted to select
best people, deserving people. And to get the deserving candidate, fair conduction of the exams is required. And more and more people should be appeared in the exams so that they can find out the best abilities. But it was possible only by providing them better books, exact syllabus. That is why to meet the demand of the candidates, means lots of people wanted to be appeared in the exam, wanted to be selected for government jobs, and they all were demanding that something should be, some study material should be provided to them. So they were demanding for the books. And to meet their demands, vast number of books were printed in China. And that technology took place. By 17th century, the use of print diversified in China because of a blooming urban culture. Actually, scientific inventions were taking place, and means it is a human nature, means day by day we move forward. So at that time also, people were shifting from agriculture sector to industrial sector. They were going from villages to urban areas. So urban culture was getting developed, and because of that, different kinds of books were in demand. And at that time, Shanghai became the hub of new printing culture. And China introduced this wood block printing technology in Japan, and after that it comes to Europe. China had a business relationship with many European countries, and through the business this technology also reaches to European countries. And by the early 15th century, wood block printing was used in Europe to print textile, playing cards, religious pictures. In 1430s, John Gutenberg, he was a German young man. He was the son of a German businessman, great businessman. He developed a printing press, and he printed, means his first printed book was Bible. At that time, that Bible got lots of popularity. It brought a revolutionary change, means it got lots of success. So my dear student, this was the starting journey or the initial journey of this printing technology. Now the question is, means when handwritten manuscripts were very beautiful, even though means handwriting was very stylish and beautiful, people were providing books by means with the help of handwritten notes, but wood block printing got lots of popularity. And what was the reason? Wood block printing technology was widely accepted by many countries. What was the reason of its worldwide popularity? Answer of this question is very simple, as I have already told you. It was better than handwritten manuscripts. But the question is, how it was better? It was better, but how? My dear students, features of handwritten manuscripts, as you can see, the heading is features of handwritten manuscripts. These features simply will answer the question, what was the reason why wood block printing technology got more popularity? Though this handwritten manuscripts had very beautiful features, even though they had their own restrictions. Like first feature, these manuscripts were prepared on palm leaves or handmade paper, and after that those pages or palm leaves were pressed between wood cover
or stitched together so that they could be preserved safely. These manuscripts were available in different native languages also. It was also a very good feature. But they were very expensive because they were very time consuming and labor consuming. On the other hand, they were very fragile also. But it was difficult to, as well as it was difficult to read them because those who used to write those books, their handwriting was very stylish. And sometimes it becomes very difficult to stylish letters. They look very beautiful. They look very attractive also. But sometimes we feel difficulty to read them. For example, like cursive writing, it looks very nice. But sometimes we feel difficult to read it. But printing letters are very clear. Each and every person can read them easily.
So, these features, we can say because of these features, handwritten manuscripts were a little bit less than woodblock printing. And not only these features, it was not possible to produce handwritten manuscripts in such a quantity also that could meet the demand for books, which always increases. Means as time passed, demand for the book was also increases, and it was felt that it was very difficult to meet the demands for the books in the market. It took lots of time and labor. It was very difficult to carry them as well as to preserve them. Means handwritten manuscripts were prepared by the people. They were writing the books with their hand. So obviously it was time taking and labor consuming. And on the other hand, with the help of wood blocks, they were printing the books. It was easy. It was less time taking. And it was easy to carry them also. That is why I have already told you that by the early 15th century, this wood block printing technology became very popular across the European countries. So, my dear students, that's all for the first part of this chapter. And in this first part, we discussed features of handwritten manuscripts. And in the other way, I can say why woodblock printing became more popular than handwritten manuscripts. In both the topics, you will describe the features of handwritten manuscripts. Another thing, the initial stage of the journey of printing technology. So these two things we studied. You can prepare your notes on the basis of these topics. We will meet in the next part. And at that time, I'll give you more questions. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.
बनी
तो बढ़िया चाहिए आज पूरी वीडियो इतनी बढ़िया बनी थी पहली वाली लेकिन